I was once told the story of a shaman who woke every single morning of his life crying for all the world's sorrow. And yet every day he would still rise and shine bright. He would walk the path from morning to night when he would light the night sky with the stars that would shine inside his dreams. And for every hell he ever saw, he made himself become the hope that tugged the rope that rang the bell in the steeple of the people's hearts. He would part the seas of greed with the outstretched hands of his giving, replacing the hate with the most amazing grace this world has ever seen. A week ago, another war started, and there wasn't a poem inside me that wasn't crying. There wasn't a poem inside me that didn't pound with the sound of 1,000 bombs screaming to where children on the ground were dying, and I didn't want to speak. I didn't want to sleep, because I didn't want to wake to another morning of mourning so many when already tombstones had paved as many prairies as highways had, and the traffic was backed up to my heart. And I didn't know where to start, like it was all too much, like I could never reach to touch a healing hand to the wounds the world stood so brutally branded with, like I couldn't bear the pain, like I could never find the strength to lift a prayer of faith beneath it all. And I felt so small, felt like we were all so small, too small to even knock a dent into the door that holds the hateful hinges of this war. And a week ago, I almost wanted to give up. But then I remember the story of the man who lived his life as a light. Through even the darkest nights, his eyes held the song of the dawn, and his sorrow was the thing that kept him moving on, kept him building a better tomorrow. I remember the story, and somewhere behind everything inside me that had felt so small, behind every voice inside me that was doubting, came a voice behind that, loud and proud, like my grandmother's voice, shouting, "What do you mean you're small? Of course you're small. We're all small. But we are small like the moon is small in the sky, and not a wave would ever find its way to shore without us. We are all as small as a single tide, but if that tide were to ever stop, the entire ocean would freeze in shock and nothing in it would survive. We are all small like the notches on the line that will one day wind a revolution through every gutter in this world, and it's time we start believing in our power, because the darkest hour will only come if we refuse to flower the light that has always burned bright inside us. So decide, what would you die for? Then live every moment of your life like you were born into this life just to save it, knowing the light at the end of the tunnel is the fire of your faith, so never put it out. And every time you start to doubt, listen to the cries of everyone who has come before you, pushing you on. They know there has never been a bomb built that could wilt the petals of your power when you allow yourself to bloom. When you bloom, there will be no room for anything else. Gandhi said, you must be the change you wish to see in the world. So you've been curled up and sad? Good. Depression is the first blessing. It means you've been in tune. But now the moon is waiting for you to burn bright, and there was never been a time when your light was needed more, never a time like this before. And yes, you were small. We are all as small as a single breath, but tied to the rest, we are all the life of the world, the pulse that turns rocks to pearls inside the darkness of their shells. So become the well where wishes are born. Become the bell that rings when even the birds refuse to sing. Become the wings that fly. And every time you're full of sorrow, every time you wake up crying, know that that day is a perfect day to shine.